All right, welcome everybody. Today is day 367 Mega Songbringer, and today I'm just doing an offline video. I'm trying out some new settings here where I've got a higher average bit rate and stuff like that, and I'm thinking, anyways, I played around with the settings and things look like I can get higher quality videos this way. Just trying around with different settings because like I really want the quality of these videos to be how they used to be, awesome. And anyways, today I'm working on the ice gate. Yesterday I finished two kinds of gates. Pretty excited about that. got the ghost sword gate. This one requires the ghost sword. That's the only way these gates will get rid of themselves. And then we also got the fire gate. Fire gate requires anything like the lighter, the fire orb, the fiery top hat, fire ghost sword. As soon as you light all the things that are supposed to be lit on fire, these gates go away. So there's two new kinds of gates there. It's gonna be super duper interesting to have the game like this with all these different gate types. It's gonna be sick. This is one of the right, like basically I want the game to you still to be able to get into like dungeon 6 or whatever, even after dungeon 1 or 2. So I'm gonna play around with how it actually blocks the player or not to get into certain kinds of dungeons. But this is gonna make the game way more interesting because right now all there are the bombable pillars, so once you have the bombs, you can get anywhere. And that's just not as interesting for a game like this, inspired by Metroid, Zelda, where your progress is dependent on you finding these items. So it creates more mystery and more intrigue and more exploration too by having these different kind of gate pillars. So this is gonna be really exciting. I'm actually really excited already just talking about it. But anyways, so today I'm gonna work on the ice sword or the ice gate. The ice gate, I've got two ideas for the ice gate. One idea is that you shoot your ghost sword or whatever you have that's icy, and it just like Crystallis, the NES game, it turns water into a solid so that you can walk on it. So if I had used the ice right here, I would be able to walk over either one or more of these blocks instead of them being water where I can't walk on it anymore. So the other idea is to make them a lot more like an actual pillar or something like that, but I don't like that idea as much because there's nine different gate types. And most of these kind of gate types are things that sink into the ground or get destroyed or whatever, like the bomb pillar is something that just gets destroyed and sinks. The fire pillar, same thing. You light the fire, it sinks. The acid pillar, that one too. You're gonna dump some acid on something, it goes away. Same thing. No, the rest of them are different. But except for ice. Ice is the question, right? And when I played, Axiom Verge is a great example of an excellent game. I love Axiom Verge so much. But I remember when I played it, I feel like they also use, the concept of like gate items. So does Metroid. So does Zelda. I don't know whether other games call them gate items or whatever, but I'm just calling them gate items. I found that if gates were the same kind of thing, but they just required a different item to pass them, they got boring. So that's why I want the ice. I'm thinking the ice is probably the best thing to do here, is to make them work differently than all the rest of these, right? That's why it would be so compelling and so interesting to have the ice sword or whatever icy thing you have turn water into a viable pathway, because it would work differently than all the other kinds of gate blocks. So without further ado, I'm going to go into my regular work mode here. I'm not going to talk as much as I do normally. I may talk a little bit because this might be more of a programming stream. I'm gonna get into my flow here, and I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope it's good quality. Get the freeze to work right. Simplicity. What? Beeps.
Thank you. Hmm.
Oh. Duh. WTF. Blaming this one on you, Xcode. Okay, well, that's it for today's stream. Video. I hope this video was way better quality than usual. You know what? Why is it just using so little CPU? It's like a game show is being like a good little child right now. So obedient. So nice. Very little CPU. Haven't had a single hiccup the entire time. It's amazing. Anyways, okay, so we're over 2 hours on this little video. Looks like I was doing a higher quality stream, like our video the whole time, but I'm not sure if I can stream this way. I think once I get above 2, that's when my internet craps out. But anyways, I hope these videos are valuable to you guys to see something in a higher resolution, higher quality with the higher resolution as well. And it's nice for me because I can just get in the flow. I don't have to, I'm a different worker when I'm live streaming versus when I'm normally working. So I hope it's valuable to see what it's like to work normally. I mean, I have no idea if that's valuable to anybody or not. But anyways, I hope this is good. So anyways, cheers, guys.